My prayer is not for them alone. I pray also for those who will believe in me through their message, that all of them may be one, Father. Just as you are in me, and I am in you, may they also be in us, so that the world may believe that you have sent me. I have given them the glory that you gave me, that they may be one as we are one. I in them, you in me. May they be brought to complete unity. Then the world will know that you sent me and have loved them even as you have loved me. Father, I want those you have given me to be with me where I am and to see my glory, the glory you have given me because you loved me before the creation of the world. Righteous Father, though the world does not know you, I know you, and they know that you have sent me. I have made you known to them, and will continue to make you known, in order that the love you have for me may be in them, and that I myself may be in them.
When we go back 20 centuries to the time of Jesus Christ and his apostles, and we apply the concept of visible unity to the early days of the church, we realize that this unity is a unity in diversity. And it is a desire and a goal maintained by the early church for many centuries.
The infilling of the Spirit, primarily, baptism of the Holy Spirit, primarily is for unity. Because God knows with the diversity within mankind, the only way he can unite us is by Spirit.
В учениците по история на църквата се говори за разцвет на църквата и периоди се описва всичко там. Аз ще ви предложа един по-друг аспект на този проблем, който ще ви се види малко странен, но сигурно ще се съгласите. На въпроса кога е разцвета на църквата, аз отговарям, че разцвета не е по време на Златния век, 4-5 век, когато има материален разцвет, а духовният разцвет, който е важен и определящ като същност на християнството, именно по време на първите времена, периодите на гонението.
You have to understand, when we speak of a persecution, when masses of people die for a message, the matter is very serious. When the original letter is written, that people should not go to murder them any longer, because Christian faith will become extinct. It means that people did not fear death. They went to death. It means that faith was taken very seriously.
So we have the Western, which has built itself upon the authority of Peter, Roman Catholicism. You have the Eastern, Greek Orthodox, which has built itself around the authority of John and his writings. And then you have the birth of Protestantism, which focuses very strongly on Pauline belief about salvation through faith. And so you have these theologies that are there. They're different voices. They do not completely agree on everything other than the fact that Jesus is the Son of God and He's God incarnate. But then you have these three traditions that are three branches of one trunk, of one tree. And I believe that they complete each other.
We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father. God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, one in being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he was born of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered, died, and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in fulfillment of the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated on the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he is worshiped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
In the different churches, the emphasis of that is another one. That they receive, that persons receive that, come to the Lord Jesus and receive him in this way. That is an individual matter. But when we speak about churches and doctrines, then there's a confrontation.
Per me l'esperienza fondamentale della fede cristiana è l'incontro con Gesù Cristo, con il suo messaggio e con la sua storia. Gesù è la via che ci porta al Padre, è la via attraverso la quale riceviamo il dono dello Spirito Santo. Senza Gesù la fede rischia di essere una filosofia, la Chiesa un'organizzazione, la missione un'attività umana.
Quando la Chiesa è divisa, il risveglio di Dio non arriva, ma quando la Chiesa è unita, ecco che la Chiesa diviene missionaria. Ma quando la Chiesa accetta la divisione, e questo è come un gas che ti addormenta e alla fine uccide la missione della Chiesa. Ecco perché è molto importante che davanti al mondo i cristiani si presentino uniti, perché se non siamo uniti il mondo non crederà alla predicazione del Vangelo, non crederà in Gesù Cristo.
And it doesn't matter whether we are Protestants, Catholics, Orthodox, of different persuasion, confessional persuasions, that is. It is important to see the seed that has been sown in Christian life.
We have to destroy the walls of separation that have kept us divided. And most of that, sadly, is theology and tradition.
Catholic Church needs to become more Christian, and the Protestant Church needs to become more Christian, and the Orthodox Church needs to become more Christian. We all need to go back to what is essential of Christianity.
They came to Capernaum. When he was in the house, he asked them, "What were you arguing about on the road?" But they kept quiet because on the way they had argued about who was the greatest. Sitting down, Jesus called the 12 and said, "Anyone who wants to be the first must be the very last and servant of all." He took a little child whom he placed among them. Taking the child in his arms, he said to them, "Whoever welcomes one of these little children in my name welcomes me, and whoever welcomes me does not welcome me, but the one who sent me."
Here we're talking about unity in love and not always unity in practice.
Let us love in truth, and truth cannot be taken away.
This is God's doing. This is not my story. This is His story. This is history in the making.
My command is this: love each other as I have loved you. Greater love hath no man than this, that a man lay down his life for his friends. You are my friends if you do what I command.
The bridge for the future unity, the unity Jesus wants, is before all the bridge of personal encounter and friendship.
If you see a brother or a sister and you have the love of God in you, and then you love the other, you are open to receive what they want to offer you. So if you love somebody genuinely with God's love, then it is a natural process.
We establish relationships out of our relationship with God because we detect the presence of God in one another. And out of these relationships, brotherly relationships, come together to worship God.
But God has put the body together, giving greater honor to the parts that lacked it, so that there should be no division in the body, but that its parts should have equal concern for each other. If one part suffers, every part suffers with it. If one part is honored, every part rejoices with it. Now you are the body of Christ, and each one of you is a part of it.
Beaucoup de femmes et d'hommes en vieillissant saisissent ce qui leur est confié. Être proche de l'autre, le libérer, le décharger du poids qui repose sur ses épaules. L'enlever tous ces 1000 kilos qu'il ne peut pas soulever, qu'il ne pourra jamais soulever. Et cela surtout par l'écoute qui louche le chemin de la confiance, de l'humble confiance, la foi.
Il regno di Dio viene a noi nelle relazioni umane. Gesù è venuto per avere relazione con l'uomo. E quindi per poter stabilire il regno di Dio oggi su questa terra abbiamo bisogno di relazionarci con i nostri fratelli e le nostre sorelle nel corpo di Cristo. E io credo che questo sia il primo passo fondamentale. Dalla mia esperienza ho potuto constatare che l'unità viene attraverso le relazioni umane. Non attraverso teorie o concetti astratti presi dalla teologia.
What will happen after we have the bridge, I really don't know. I don't believe in merger. I don't believe that we will do away with our distinctiveness or with our particularity as a tradition or traditions. I believe that this is a way to build a bridge, to live in peace and be one in faith and one in love and mutual recognition for the cause of the dying world.
If we walk in the light, we shall have fellowship with each other. And if we do not walk in the light, if there's not the revelation of God, and if there's not the light of Christ in our lives, we shall have no fellowship. And that's not even a question about the diversity between the Catholics and the Orthodox and the Protestants. That's a question about the diversity among the Protestants and among the Catholics themselves and among the Greeks. This is the clear teaching of the Word of God. If you walk in the light, you will have fellowship with each other.
I appeal to you, brothers and sisters, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, that all of you agree with one another in what you say, and that there be no divisions among you, but that you be perfectly united in mind and thought.
If you want to build the unity, you must go, you must open the windows. You must not stay in a place waiting, but you have to go. You have to work with others.
Do not merely listen to the word and so deceive yourselves. Do what it says. Anyone who listens to the word but does not do what it says is like someone who looks at his face in the mirror and, after looking at himself, goes away and immediately forgets what he looks like. But whoever looks intently into the perfect law that gives freedom and continues in it, not forgetting what they have heard, but doing it, they will be blessed in what they do.
I think we have, as human beings, lived long enough after the days of Christ to be able to look back with the motivation to learn positively, not just look in a negative way and label people, just as we label today one another.
We live in an age where the dark becomes darker and the light becomes lighter, and it's just like people feel that there is so much dark, and when they just see a little bit spot of light, they understand that there is something different. And I've seen young people being very thirsty for that hope and that light, because they're just tired of so much philosophy.
I believe, yes, we are afraid, because a lover does not afraid. He is in love. He doesn't fear anything.
We need to adapt to the timing of God. And it might take 40 years, it might take 400 years, we don't know. We know that God is sovereign, that his hands are on history. We know what his direction is, you know, is clearly written in the gospel. You know, he wants the church to be one, visibly one. So we are committed to that, but the timing is in the hands of God.
Then Jesus came to them and said, "All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Therefore, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you. And surely I am with you always, to the very end of the age."
The principal agent of ecumenical work is not a human being, is the Holy Spirit. So to be open to the work of the Spirit, also to the imagination of the Spirit, open to the newness that he wants to produce in your life and in the life of the church.
So even though you and I may not be agreeing on doctrine, we both live a life filled with the Spirit, and we recognize we are brother and sister, brothers and brothers, sisters and sisters, but yet we are different on doctrine.
Dobbiamo trovare un accordo per costruire l'unità. La nostra comunione più profonda ha a che fare con lo Spirito Santo. È lui che crea l'unità, e quindi dobbiamo relazionarci con i nostri fratelli nello Spirito Santo. E questo può avvenire attraverso la nostra amicizia.
Since we live by the Spirit, let us keep in step with the Spirit. Let us not become conceited, provoking and envying each other.
Very often we have labeling processes from Protestants to Catholics, Catholic, Roman Catholics, or Eastern Catholics to Orthodox, from Orthodox to their counterparts. I truly believe that God has allowed Christian multiplicity to live even in the confessions. There are strong traits in each one of the confessions that resemble strongly the initial message of Jesus Christ. There is something that each one is holding on to, that we may learn from each other at a grassroots level or at an institutional level.
Be completely humble and gentle. Be patient, bearing with one another in love. Make every effort to keep the unity of the Spirit through the bond of peace. There is one body and one Spirit. Just as you were called to one hope when you were called, one Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God and Father of all, who is over all, and through all, and in all.
The courage to want the dream of God and to walk through this dream, also paying personally a personal contribution, also a personal sacrifice to this aim of the unity that Christ wants.
It was very late at night, and we're sitting eating, and this sweet, and I want to emphasize, sweet nun, went. She said to me, she said, "Benny, come here." So I said, "Okay, I didn't know where I'm going." She takes me up, and I'll never forget this, takes me up these stairs. We go like this. They went like that, like in a circle. Go upstairs, and she looks at me. She says, "This is my prayer room. The minute I knelt, the Lord became so real to me, I began weeping. And not only did he become real, I could see him." It was a very amazing, holy experience for me. The second I closed my eyes, I saw this figure in white in front of me. And I start crying, the tears began to flow. Now I don't want to go nowhere. This went on for 20 minutes. She's crying, I'm crying. Jesus is real to both of us. So she and I help each other up because we were a little wobbly, to be honest with you, the power of God was strong. So we both get up. I said to her, "Sister, I'm learning now something about the Lord." And I looked at her, I said, "You know what I'm discovering? I don't think it matters to him what we believe, as long as we believe in him." And that sister just smiled from ear to ear. She said, "That's exactly right, man. It's not about theology, it's about Jesus."
So that, with one mind and one voice, you may glorify the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. Accept one another, then, just as Christ accepted you, in order to bring praise to God.
You must welcome the diversity. You must respect and to be so open to the otherness of the other means to be humble, to be ready to learn from the other one with which you talk and you try to build the future of the unity.
The unity of diversity. To be visibly united simply means the unification, the uniting together. We should maybe use the word togetherness more than unity, because the word unity means together. It doesn't mean being the same, uniformity. It means being together. We need to bring our diversity together that we enrich each other, like I've experienced. And that with this rich, united togetherness, we can show Jesus to the world in a very, very spectacular way.
Non sempre le nostre differenze sono delle divisioni. Le nostre differenze rappresentano una ricchezza e dobbiamo essere aperti gli uni agli altri per ricevere il dono di una chiesa all'altra.
In your relationships with one another, have the same mindset as Christ Jesus, who, being in very nature God, did not consider equality with God something to be used to his own advantage. Rather, he made himself nothing by taking the very nature of a servant, being made in human likeness, and being found in appearance as a man. He humbled himself by becoming obedient to death, even death on a cross.
Le chemin de la foi, ce n'est pas notre voie, mais celle où, peu à peu, on saisit que la foi est une réalité très, très humble, très... qui ne demande pas des efforts surhumains, non, non, du tout. Mais beaucoup plus une attitude intérieure de simplicité pour comprendre ce que Dieu a déposé en nous.
I believe with all my heart that the church of Jesus is way bigger than we make it. Because you have Catholics, you have Orthodox, you have all kinds of groups around the world that love Jesus, that love the Lord.
And I learned a lot about things I never knew about, sacramental life. And so because of that, I realized that there was much more that they could give me that I could give them. And that birthed a friendship, a true relationship, where I would give them what I had and they would give me what they had. And they made me a better Christian.
Penso che dovremmo imparare a distinguere le nostre tradizioni dalla tradizione. Le tradizioni possono cambiare o anche essere tralasciate. La sfida della nostra Chiesa, per le nostre Chiese, penso che sia riconoscere la tradizione come un canale che lascia passare l'acqua viva della parola di Dio per dissetare gli uomini di ogni tempo.
When you address traditions like the Catholic or the Eastern Orthodox, you're addressing a massive body of people, massive communities. And sometimes in those traditions, you have a blend between Christian faith and ethnicity or ethnical belonging. So when people say I'm a Christian, they mean I'm Bulgarian or I'm British or I'm North American. And they do not exactly address the content of Christian faith. So we have a very big division, unfortunately, between the theology of the church and the common practice of the church. When it comes to the theology of the church, the three traditions absolutely agree on the fundamentals.
I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me.
The truth is not something that you possess, but someone who possesses you, Christ. So if you want to build the future of the unity, you must be a very docile, very open to the work of Christ in your life, to the kingdom of God that comes.
I cristiani, quando si incontrano, devono mettere al centro della loro relazione Gesù Cristo come unico Signore e Salvatore e adorarlo. E quando i cristiani insieme adorano l'unico Signore, le nostre differenze non salgono al cielo.
Quando impareremo ad ascoltare insieme la parola di Dio, forse riusciremo anche a interpretarla meglio.
The kingdom has nothing to do with denominations and churches and groups and people and theology. It has to do with God's purpose, divine purpose on earth. And I'm one that believes in that with all my heart and being. And really the kingdom of God is the message of unity, because the Lord never preached division and different groups identifying themselves by some whatever theology they believe in. What he was talking about is he, the head of the church.
We are brothers and sisters in Christ, not in each other. You need a third person to be united. You have diversity I can't accept. I have diversity you can't accept. We could never be one together. But with Christ who accepts you and your diversity, and Christ who accepts me and my diversity, you and I find ourselves together in Christ. We need a third person to reconcile our differences. We don't really need to agree on everything. We just need to agree that Christ loves us both equally, and therefore we are brothers and sisters.
As Jesus Christ said in the Gospels, there is the parable of the sower who went out to sow the seed. And there were different types of soil. One soil was shallow, another was deep, another was good and gave fruit manifold. Even so, the fruits are not the same. We are many and different in the kingdom of God. In that sense, unity is not unification. As somehow humanity has been used to think of unity in the post-enlightenment period of life. But unity is life in multiplicity, in appreciation of the other, in appreciation of what Christ has done for us.
Let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, since as members of one body, you were called to peace. And be thankful. Let the message of Christ dwell among you richly as you teach and admonish one another with all wisdom through psalms, hymns, and songs from the Spirit, singing to God with gratitude in your hearts. And whatever you do, whether in word or deed, do it all in the name of Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through Him.
You must be open to the dream of God, open to the work of the Spirit. Your heart must be not closed in itself, but very, very ready to learn, to accept, to renew your life so that your life can be a sign of the charity of God for all this.
We are looking forward to a new heaven and a new earth where righteousness dwells. So then, dear friends, since you are looking forward to this, make every effort to be found spotless, blameless, and at peace with Him.
Και να ο Λόγος του Θεού να πάρει δύναμη μέσα στη ζωή τους. Γιατί εάν είμαστε παιδιά αναγεννημένα του ίδιου πατέρα και έχουμε ένα νέο πνεύμα, αυτό από μόνο του φέρνει ενότητα.
And if we can stand up together and visibly say we are one in the faith and one in mission, the whole world will see our visible unity and they will believe.
I have an optimistic view. I believe that finally the church will come together and will prepare itself, as it says the Bible, you know, as the bride to meet the bridegroom, Jesus Christ. I'm sure that this is the vision of the New Testament, and so that we should cultivate this understanding, this vision. We should encourage the Christians, wherever we are in our roles, in our responsibilities, to cultivate this perspective. The end is clear, is revealed in the Bible and the New Testament. At the end, God would win.
A priest, a friend of mine, that told me before a couple of years, don't you know a high-level person here in Orthodox Church to help you? And I said, yes, of course I know. I know God. What else should I know?
Аз си Отец ме едно и бъдете едно както аз и Отец ме едно.
Then I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth had passed away, and there was no longer any sea.
La bienveillance vous construit. Se détruire soi-même par sévérité, très 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 délicat. La sévérité pour soi-même, elle nous ébranle, elle nous éparpille aussi. Elle ne nous place pas dans une voie d'unité. Et comme le tréfonds de tout ici à Thésée, dès le départ, c'était que se construise quelque part un lieu où l'on se réconcilie tous les jours entre hommes, avec mes frères. Alors, me pousser à chercher, mais qu'est-ce qui peut créer en toi cette force unity, cette force de réconciliation, de bienveillance du cœur, de...
The church of Christ is like the robe of Christ, the garment that he was dressed with when he was crucified. The soldiers could not tear it to pieces, so they had to cast lot who is going to take it. In its very nature, in the core of its own being, the church cannot be divided.
There is road, and I think we can return to the oldest metaphor for Christians, people on the way. If we are people on the way, I believe today we must be looking again to start treading on that way toward Christ and toward the other.
Can you imagine if just under 3 billion people in the earth decide to stand together in their diversity, share their gifts that they have, share, put their resources together, network. What do you think that 3 billion people could do for this world?
Jesus knew that the Father had put all things under his power, and that he had come from God and was returning to God. So he got up from the meal, took off his outer clothing, and wrapped a towel around his waist. After that, he poured water into a basin and began to wash his disciples' feet, drying them with the towel that was wrapped around him. Now that I, your Lord and teacher, have washed your feet, you should also wash one another's feet. I have set you an example that you should do as I have done for you. I tell you the truth, no servant is greater than his master, nor is a messenger greater than the one who sent him. Now that you know these things, you will be blessed if you do them.
Thank you.
we could come together, we could change this world.